This tool will just blow your mind. And from now on, you'll use it every day to answer questions like, can you show me how to add a new opportunity in Salesforce? How do I turn on polls in Zoom meetings? How can I order your best-selling product? Could you please show me how to create a template in Canva.com? Please teach me how to post a job in LinkedIn. What are the steps to input a picture into Zoom whiteboard? How do I open a Google Doc?
How can I do this? How can I do that?
Tango is the free Chrome extension that will allow you to create written how-to step-by-step guides in real time and without the need of recording a video. Tango automatically captures the steps on your Chrome browsers as you do the work. It takes screenshots, it describes the action, and includes the URL of the page you're working on. By the time you're done, Tango has already produced a step-by-step written guide that you can review, edit, and personalize as you wish. Once you're happy with the result, just share the guide with your teammates or export a PDF to be included in your learning management system. Tango is perfect if you have to create onboarding guides, provide instructions to customers, share tips and tricks with your colleagues, or create standard operating procedures. Let's go install it and try it. Tango is a free Google Chrome extension. To install it, let's go to tango.us and then click on Add to Chrome. You'll be taken to the Chrome Web Store. Here, just click on Add to Chrome. You can then sign up for Tango with your Google account or with email. When done, Tango will ask you a couple of simple questions. I'm not sure, but I don't think they're going to use your answer to customize your Tango experience. They probably just want to profile their users. Anyway, let's answer the questions, after which you'll be taken to your Tango homepage that is called My Workflows. Here, you'll be able to collect all your guides, tutorials, however you want to call them. Tango calls them workflows. By default, you'll find two workflows that are already prepared for you. These are the essential guides to learn how to pin the Chrome extension and how to capture your first workflow. So let's see how Tango works. To do that, I've taken a simple question from a colleague. That was, how do I activate the polls option in Zoom? Instead of starting a Zoom meeting, sharing screen and showing him how to do that, or instead of writing a step-by-step description in the Teams chat, with Tango I will just do it, and the tool will record the essential steps for me and produce a guide that is there to stay. And be sure next time I get the same question from another colleague. The first step is to open the Chrome window where you want to record the workflow. So in my case, I've opened the Zoom web client. If you've pinned Tango to the taskbar, you'll find the icon at the top right. Click on it, and when ready, just click on Capture Workflow. As the message says, now the capture has started. It's important to notice that Tango is not recording a video. Instead, it will select the important actions you're performing on the website and will put together a guide made of screenshots and descriptions. You don't have to worry too much if you're hesitating on the page or if you're making a mistake, because at the end you'll be able to edit your workflow. As the capture starts, then a simple toolbar will appear on the left. You'll have a number indicating the step of the workflow, then a green check icon confirming that Tango is capturing, a pause button, an undo button, and a trash button, in case you want to start your capture from the beginning. With the last two arrows button, you can move the toolbar to the right or the left, if, as in my case, it's covering important content that you need to see. Since I'm actively working on the left part of the page, I'll move it to the right. I can move the mouse on the page, and Tango will not record anything, but when I click on Settings, it will recognize I've done an action and capture it as a workflow step. Now the number in the toolbar has changed to 2, indicating that Tango is ready to record step 2. Now I'll click on In Meeting Basic, and this is going to be recorded as a new step. Then scroll down and toggle the button Meeting Polls Quizzes. That's going to be recorded as step 4. I'm done. To complete the capture, I have to click on the green button. Tango now automatically creates the workflow and presents it. It only takes a few seconds and the workflow is ready. We can now edit it to add information or change the instructions that were automatically generated by Tango. I start by giving it a title and call it Enable Polls in Zoom. Instead of Go to My Profile Zoom, I prefer calling this step Open the Zoom Web Client. Step number 2 looks good, as well as step number 3 and 4. Just one second, if you like what you're seeing, please hit the subscribe button and like this video. Back to the tutorial now. I realized that I want to provide additional information on how to access the web client settings. To do that, just click on plus to add a step. There are two options. The first one is Insert Step and will allow you to manually upload content and add a description. The second one is Capture Steps, Let's look into the first option and keep the second one for later. Zoom web client settings can also be accessed by clicking on a hyperlink in the desktop client. Tango can automatically record steps only from a Chrome window. So whatever happens outside of a Chrome window needs to be imported. So I'll take a screenshot of the desktop client settings and upload this image to create the new step. By hovering over the image, I can now click on the edit icon to add some additional information. To make the instruction clearer, I'll use a red rectangle and insert an arrow. It's actually better to have this new step in the third position. To change the position, just go to the left panel and drag and drop the step as needed. Let me slightly modify the text in the step. I'll make the title concise and add more details in the description. I would also add a short description after the title. Now you can see that at the bottom of each step there is a link to page. Tango records the URL of the page you're on, and if you want it to appear on your guide, just leave it as is. For this guide, it doesn't make sense to provide the URL to my profile, as each URL will be different for each user. So I'll just remove the link for each step. Another very useful tool is the possibility to blur out part of your screenshot that contains sensitive information that you don't want to share. I've already blurred out my sensitive information in post-production, but let me now show you how to do it in Tango when producing a guide. Just go to your screenshot, click on the edit icon, and then select Blur Editor. Select the area that you want to blur out, click on Apply, and voila, as simple as that. I've now removed the blur that I inserted in post-production and just left the blur effect provided by Tango. To make instructions even clearer, I will add some graphic elements to the pictures. I will now add a step number 6, just to confirm that the guide is complete. But wait, I've realized that the guide only covers how to activate polls in Zoom meetings. I want to add a step to show how to activate polls in Zoom webinars. I will add a step after step 5, and this time choose Capture Steps. Tango will ask me to select the Chrome window where I want to record the additional step, so I'll choose the Zoom one. I'll toggle Webinar Polls Quizzes button, and that's done. The new step has been created. To be noted that Tango has automatically zoomed in to what it thinks is the relevant part of the screenshot. However, if you wish, you can zoom out or zoom in to another area. And let's add again a rectangle, an arrow, and some text. I'll update the descriptions, and that's it. We can now preview the workflow to check out what the end user will see. Users will be able to zoom in and out of each screenshot as they wish. If you're happy with your guide, it's now time to share it and export it. You can share it via email or with a link, and you can decide whether they'll only be able to view it or edit it. You can copy the workflow into any product that supports HTML or download a PDF file that, for example, you can upload in your learning management system. This tool is just great. Wait, last second update. I was about to publish the video when I received this email by Tango. First of all, announcing that they won number one product of the week, and I think that's well deserved. But the key information here is that in the upcoming weeks, they will be releasing product updates, pricing plans, and more goodies. They're also reassuring that they will have a free version similar to the one that I've shown you in my video. That's definitely good news. I love this tool, and in the future I will make new videos as soon as they release updates. So make sure you subscribe and stay tuned. What you can do for you right now is to watch this next video to further enhance your productivity and communication skills.